got a flat house drawing, front and side view, but it looks pretty boring, right? What if I told you that with just 2 points, you can turn it into an incredible 3D modern house? Today, we're taking an ordinary plan and transforming it right in front of your eyes into a modern home that looks real. Get ready, because with this technique, your drawings are going to jump to a whole new level. Before we start drawing the modern house, let's quickly review how two-point perspective works. First, we set the horizon line. Then, we place one vanishing point on the left and one on the right. From now on, every horizontal line will head toward one of these 2 points. We have the front and side views of the concept. These give us the proportions, floor height, and details of the house. Now, using these 2D drawings as a guide, we'll build the three-dimensional view. First, I use construction lines to create the draft. Then I start by defining the corner of the house. After that, we direct the right and left facades toward the two vanishing points. As you may have noticed, I'm not drawing just from my wrist. I'm using the longer muscles of my whole arm. Instead of a single line, I sketch with multiple construction lines. This makes a drawing feel more natural and helps it settle into place. By practicing straight, vertical, and horizontal lines, as well as ellipses every day, you can strengthen the foundation of your drawing skills. Over time, this will allow you to create more detailed and complex works. It's really not that hard. If you practice enough, all the limitations will disappear. The house is slowly starting to take shape. Remember, in the beginning, always think of the structure as a simple box. Once the foundation is in place, we'll gradually move into the details. That's our basic rule. When building the structure, it's important that all of my lines lead back to the perspective points. This ensures the drawing stays accurate and the form looks realistic. And remember, the horizon line represents our current eye level. It's important to align the floor height according to the height of a human figure. As we move forward, keep in mind that perspective is the backbone of architectural drawing. It's what allows us to translate flat ideas into realistic three-dimensional spaces. Every line, every corner, and every angle should respect the vanishing points. This is what gives the building its depth and believability. Another thing to keep in mind is balance. Architecture is not only about proportions, but also about harmony. A modern house, for example, often combines simple geometric forms with open spaces and large windows. These design choices make the building feel both functional and aesthetically pleasing. Now that the main structure of the house is starting to come together, we can add a bit of landscaping. Sidewalks and green areas are important, as they will bring a sense of naturalness and harmony to our house drawing. At this stage, we can move on to the details of our drawing. Flower pots, plant arrangements, doors and windows will now start to take shape. Our sketch is now complete, and it's time to bring out the clean and precise lines. For this, I'm starting to use my 0.2 technical pen. Since the 0.2 feels a bit too thin, I'm switching to 0.3 pen and continuing the work. At this stage, once I'm done, I start erasing the underlying sketch lines and continue with shading lines. The techniques I use most are hatching and cross-hatching, and they work really well with the technical pen, giving excellent results. And don't forget light. Even though we're just sketching, imagine where the sun would hit the walls or how shadows would fall. This mindset will help you bring life and atmosphere into your work later on. Shading with the rapidograph pen is a skill that develops over time. For darker textures, the pen should be applied with firm strokes, while for softer textures, it should be used lightly and more superficially. In architecture, landscaping plays a crucial role in creating harmony between the building and its surroundings. Elements such as trees, green areas, pathways, and open spaces don't just add beauty, they also improve the functionality and livability of the design. A well-planned landscape softens the rigid lines of the structure, provides balance, and connects the architecture to nature. Landscaping can also guide movement, define spaces, and create a welcoming atmosphere. Whether it's a simple garden, a row of trees, or carefully placed flower beds, these details give the project a sense of completeness and make it feel alive. I'm getting close to finishing the drawing, but the windows still look too flat. To make them more realistic, I'm adding reflections and allowing a slight glimpse of the interior of the house. With the final touches, we're now completing our drawing. Thank you so much for watching. Your support means a lot for us to keep creating more drawings. See you next time.